Continuing with factoring out the greatest common factor, let's review. If we were to factor xy minus 3y, y is the common factor, and so we get a y times x minus 3. Now instead, let's say this problem had been x times 2x plus 1 minus 3 times 2x plus 1. This actually is similar to xy minus 3y, except that the common factor is 2x plus 1 as opposed to y. So this is not factored because there's a big fat minus sign here, but each term is factored. So you could think of this as the difference of two terms. Just like in this first problem, xy minus 3y, that was the difference of two terms. Each term happens to be factored, but the entire polynomial is not factored. So now we're going to try to factor by looking to see if there's a common factor, and that would be the 2x plus 1. So since 2x plus 1 is a factor in each of those two terms, we could pull that out to the front just like we pulled out the y to the front. And I think of it as pulling out to the front because what would be left is your x here to get back to x times 2x plus 1 minus, because of the minus sign, and 3 to get back to 3 times 2x plus 1. And so this actually is equal to this. So we're taking it to the next step here. All right, let's do another one. A times x minus y plus b times x minus y. Find the common factor in each of the two terms, pull it out to the front, and then so write this in factored form. All right, the common factor is x minus y, so we can pull that out to the front, and that gives us A plus B. Okay, now you can actually convince yourself these are the same if you'd like by doing the distributive property on this top line here and then doing the FOIL method and multiplying this out here, and you'll see that you'll get the same four terms either way. Alright, let's go to one more. This one's slightly tricky. Again, we have two terms with a big fat minus sign in the middle. So we're looking for the common factor in each of the terms, and hopefully you note that that is 3m minus 1. So we could pull that out to the front. And then here's the problem. Be very careful. See if you can figure out what goes in the parentheses. Well, from the first term we have 5x, but now it's the second one that's tricky. Minus what? What goes there? Might not see it, but it's a 1, right? If there's nothing in front of that parentheses, you can imagine it's a 1, right? I know it really wasn't there, right? But if you want, you can write a 1 down, which I'm doing in red, so it's clear that you can see that that really is always there. Okay, even if only in your mind. Okay, next tricky one. We have x times a minus b plus y times b minus a. They have no factors in common. A minus b is not the same as b minus a. But from an earlier video, a minus b and b minus a are opposites. Therefore, and I always do this on the second term over here, if I keep this as a minus b, I would like this to also be a minus b. To make up for that, I need to change the sign here from a plus to a minus. Now I want you to convince yourself that's the same thing. We've gone over this before. These are opposites, so b minus a really is the same thing as like a negative 1 times a minus b. That's why this works. So if you look up at the top, we have y b minus y a, And here I have a minus yA and a plus yB. Actually, those are exactly the same. So if you did multiply out the second part here doing the distributive property, notice you'd have a yB and a minus yA. And if I did the second part down here, I'd have a minus yA and a plus yB. And yes, those are actually equal. And so I'm okay. All right, so what do we do now? Now I see that the common factor is a minus b, and that can then be pulled out to the front, and I have x minus y. Be careful that you don't simply say that that's x plus y times a minus b or x plus y times b minus a. You have to first rewrite it so that what's in parentheses is exactly the same thing. All right, so let's see if you could do one like that. Let's do 3x, 1 minus 2y, minus 5, times 2y minus 1. This is similar, but it's, you know, slightly different. Go ahead and try it, put it on pause, and then come back. Okay, well, we've got 1 minus 2y, and we have 2y minus 1. Those are opposites. Remember, this only works if there's a minus sign. If I had 1 plus 2y, that's not going to be the opposite of 2y plus 1 or 2y minus 1. All right, so I'm going to adjust the second one again. So I have 3x times 1 minus 2y. And if I'm going to change that to 1 minus 2y, I have to change this sign here to a plus. All right, now we have a common factor of 1 minus 2y times 3x plus 5. And again, you can verify these are really the same by taking the original problem, doing the distributive property, and you're going to get four terms after you combine like terms, etc., if there are any to combine. You'll get the same thing if you do the FOIL method on this third one, this third line. Doing the kind of problems I'm showing you in this video, these are the tricky ones. All right, let's look at this one. Are there any common factors between the two terms being subtracted? No. All right, what about opposites? Are there some opposites that you might be able to deal with it? No. 2x minus 3 and 2x plus 3 are not opposites, so you can't go any further. So you can't pull out GCF. Okay, so be careful. They have to really be opposites. Now, if I had instead done this problem, 2x minus 3, and in here I put 3 minus 2x, well, then we could do the little adjustment to get this to be a 2x minus 3. I have to do the opposite in front because that's like multiplying by negative 1. So 2x minus 3, and then we could pull that 2x minus 3 out to the front, and 5x plus y again. Sometimes you'll see opposites, but it won't be because one will be 2x minus 3 and the other 3 minus 2x. They'll just be written in a form where it's obvious they're, you've got the opposite sign in front of each parentheses. So let's say you had 2y times negative 2x plus 5 plus 3 times 2x minus 5, for instance. So when you're looking at this one, you could say, well, is what's in parentheses exactly the same? No, because I have a negative 2x plus 5, and over here I have a positive 2x minus 5. But these are still just opposites, aren't they? So again, I have to do some adjustment. Now, you could make the adjustment either way. Watch what I'm going to do here. I'm going to write this as 5 minus 2x. It's a little bit easier when whatever in the parentheses does not start with a minus sign. So I have this. So all I did was rewrite negative 2x plus 5 as 5 minus 2x. And now I notice, well, they're opposites. I do the adjustment. Minus 3 times 5 minus 2x. And now I could take out the 5 minus 2x. And 2x minus 3. And I'll be done.